So, practice and relationships. It's not uncommon when one or both partners begin the path of practice that there can be a certain measure of tension. Even if both people jump in, there's always going to be one who's more engaged or more keen, more committed than the other. It's just the way it is. Sometimes, and perhaps just as commonly, it could be one partner very fascinated, very wanting to engage in this dimension of life, and the other partner with other interests entirely. And then the worry with the second partner is that the practice, the meditation, is going to perhaps change their partner beyond all recognition, going to make them less interested in actually continuing or fostering the relationship, going to make them weird, going to turn them into some kind of robot. There's a kind of a fear of the unknown. And, you know, this is a perfectly legitimate thing. Now, mostly I get to work with the active partner, if you like, the one who wants to engage, wants to jump in, wants to do this sort of thing. And I tend to recommend to go very cautiously, to take things very gently. This is a marathon, not a sprint. There's absolutely no need to turn your life upside down in jumping in and doing this work. And in fact, that's nearly always a tremendously bad idea. Now, what I found happens is that the one thing that can really help the harmony of the relationship is time. There's been a fair bit of research around the effects of meditation, mindfulness, Zen practice, and so on. And one of the fairly reliably established shifts is in empathy. And this is just makes total sense if you think about it. Most of us are a dustbin. We're carrying around a bunch of old stuff from the past, a bunch of pain, suffering, sometimes absolute nonsense. But the more stuff of this type that we're carrying around in life, the less headspace we've got to actually be genuinely present with our other half, with our partner, and with other people within our lives. Now, practice, when it's done properly, is a process of, as it were, emptying out the dustbin. As we gradually, over time, empty out all of this stuff, you know, bit by bit, even if there's still a lot left, nevertheless, we make more space. That space enables us to be more present, more empathetic with our partner. Our partner doesn't need anything sold to them. They pick that up. I mean, pretty quickly, that becomes very clear. And this process, this, as it were, emptying out process can, when practice is done right, can pretty much start immediately from the word go. So now the partner, even if they're not a practitioner themselves, they start to realize, my partner's actually more there for me. They're actually more awake. They're more tuned in. They're more present. This is a good thing. So then, rather than the suspicion, the worry, it becomes, have you done your meditation yet today? You know, they actually become a supporter of your practice, an advocate for your practice, even if it's absolutely not something that they are interested in themselves. So this is pretty common, pretty reliable, near enough 100% of people in a close relationship, in my experience, seem to experience this kind of arc, if you like. So the key thing is to take it gently, to not cause any more ripples at the beginning than you absolutely have to. You can even make a joke out of your practice. Oh, I'm on my meditation kick, whatever. You know, make it sort of normal, make it even a bit boring, you know. The further that you can sort of go away from giving any kind of an impression that you're turning into some kind of cult zombie, which, you know, if you're doing it right, of course you're not, then it's all to the good. And if you're doing it right, this is a good indicator for you as well. If you're doing it right, you should be becoming a kinder, gentler, more present person. If that ain't there, then that's cause for examination. Something needs to be seen there. So if you do this right, I think we can pretty confidently guarantee it's going to be a beneficial influence within the sphere of your relationship.